black nipples, cocaine in the operating room.
Yeah.
And
hey, hold on, Adam in Harwood. We're coming to you in a second. Michelle from Middle River said she had the breast reduction done when she was 21, mm-hmm. and she was a smoker, and she says her nipples are just fine.
Okay.
They were placed too high. They said that her nipples were placed too high. Is that possible? But they're still there.
Whip, firm, and high.
Man. And also, it's medical grade cocaine that they give you, and it's liquid, a texter says. It's been used as an anesthetic since the early 1900s. I thought so. Watch the show, The Nick, on HBO. It's about a famous surgeon in the early 20th century addicted to the cocaine that he gave patients during surgery as an anesthetic.
That makes sense.
All right, Adam in Harwood. Kirk and Marianne, what's up, bro?
Hey, what's going on, fella? How are you guys doing?
We're good. Hi.
Well, you know.
You guys were talking about, was it pigskin?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I actually had open heart surgery, and I have a swine valve.
Ooh.
It's
kind of trippy.
Yeah.
The funny thing is that I had gout, like, really bad. It was part of, like, the disease. They put the swine in. Valve in. Haven't had gout since.
Haven't had gout. Hey, let me ask you this. When you laugh, do you go, you ever...
No, well, I mean, a little bit, but it's not. It was a little bit more than it used to be here.
It's developed a snort.
Were you nervous about getting another animal's? I'm sure it's routine now.
You don't feel it.
Yeah. You don't feel it, but you still, I probably would think about it before they did it.
Do you actually have a cow and a swine? I have two of them.
Wow.
You okay?
You're a one-man barn.
Yeah, one-man petting zoo.
Yeah, I wouldn't care. Yeah, as long as it works.
It's working, too. When did you have it? Because you're still here.
37. I'm 41 now.
Okay. Anything you can't do? They say no marathons, maybe don't drink, no smoking.
I have dreams about running, but, yeah, I don't do that anymore.
You're not allowed to run?
Well, I can, but, I mean, it's up to me, you know.
Oh, you're just lazy. It's the pig valve made you lazy. It'll probably be good for your heart. Go for a little jog.
Mm.
Yeah, it's just been a bed. Okay. Yeah.
All right. Hey, thanks a lot.
Very cool.
Swine valve surgery.
Different.
Yeah, all right. See you guys. Thank you. I love you guys.
Thanks for listening.
Love you too, man.
Love you too.
Love your beef and pork products too.
Yeah. He's a barbecue. That's interesting. Somebody said human cadaveric skin can be used, and they will know. Okay, so they'll know. That guy knew about it before they put it
in. Yeah, they'll let you know first, and I guess you can make a decision. If that's not for you, you say, hey, whoa.
Right, I'm more of a cow.
Yeah, can we try something else?
Right.
Hey, paper straw?
Any people tubes? You take what you can get. Pandemic, there is a shortage of everything.
You want to live? You're going pig valve.
Yeah.
Okay.
Or maybe a synthetic would be nice.
I'll do whatever they tell me to.
Plastic. Yeah, what am I gonna look it up? All right, well, let's see. What's that one there?
This is medical cocaine.
Ooh.
Hey, who are you? Anonymous? Anon. It's you now. Hey, what's going on? It's Chris.
Hi, Chris.
Hi, guys. How are you?
Good.
Tell us what you know.
I had an ENT give me some of that medical-grade cocaine, and it was amazing.
Where were you? At the hospital, or were you in a parking lot somewhere?
Yeah, right. No, it was in his office. And so he squirted up one nostril, squirted up the other, and he waited 20 minutes and came back. My whole face was numb. And I could feel drips going down my throat all the way to like almost my stomach.
Was it fun? It doesn't sound like a good time.
I couldn't put a glass of water to my mouth and drink it for at least an hour.
It's like you got dental work done.
It would have just spilled out everywhere.
Yeah, you know how to party.
You got that bombshell.
The next time I went in and he did it again because he had to scope me, he squirted it in each nostril and he set it on the counter and he left. And I thought to myself, I should take that bottle right there.
Why? It doesn't sound like fun at all.
Who is this doctor?
Well, I probably could have sold it for a lot of money.
Is this doctor legitimate? Is he a friend of yours?
Yeah.
100% legit ENT.
Oh, EMT. Doesn't sound ethical to me, but...
Here, inhale this.
Yeah, and I'm going to leave the room and I'm going to leave this
bottle.
You want
to dribble some water tonight?
I would have dumped it.
I think he was tempting me.
He might have had one of those cameras in the room, keeping an eye, seeing if you're... honest or not. You were honest, though.
That's great.
It was good, though. It was really good. I mean, I don't know what cocaine is like, but...
You do. Now you do.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's not cocaine. Yeah. Like the normal experience.
It's put in my medical records that I was administered cocaine.
Yeah.
And when I went to join the military, they looked at it and looked at me, and I was in a room full of people, and they're like, why do you have cocaine on your medical record? The doctor gave it to me.
Yeah.
That's a nice place to have a conversation about your record.
Why do you have cocaine in your wallet?
Well, it's the military. They don't care.
Thanks for the laugh, Chris.